tug. This is also long tug. But on the left side, to make it work, you kind of have to turn your gun forward. So you keep your hand a little bit like that, so that when you bring it off your shoulder, it does make a direct straight line. But Bill Bringer says specifically never to throw blows from the left anyway, because you're not strong from the left side. If you're a right-handed fencer, you throw from the right. If you're a left-handed fencer, you throw from the left. So we have long tug. And then we have my favorite food. That means the plow. Imagine you're a medieval peasant holding a plow in the earth as you're walking behind the ox. So that's food. You want it away from your head, unlike Remy. You want to have it point towards your opponent. And you're always going to have your sword where your feet are not. You're always going to be the three-legged stool where if your sword's on the right, your foot's on the left. So if we transition over to the left side, our right foot is now forward. And again, the point's on your opponent's face, and we can go back like this. Next guard is ox, where we bring it up next to our head, not as far back as the speaking window, but it's not a hanger, a forward hanger either, it's not a long gut, it's an ox. The horns of the ox pointing downwards. That's one of those few cases where the English and the German are the same. So, we can go bring over to the other side. Here's our left ox. Very good. And just to demonstrate, these four guards form. You can go up into any one of those four. What I call the cone of tragedy, which is where if you keep this point on the same place, you go down into the flute, bring it out to the side. There are almost fully extended there. See you up there. You'll find that you can form a nice smooth cone just by going through to the other side. You can go up there, and then up the ox. One of the other points you might want to try is bring the wings up like that.
Okay.
You'll see some people when they're doing the German, they will have it with their wings straight up and down. But turned outwards, probably inwards, never this. That just means your hands are going to get hit every time. A little bit outwards like that. That means your flute and your ox are in the same hand orientation. And if we pass through, you go up like that. Turn your pillions out the other way. You turn them in too far. There you go. Too much.
So your quillions are between your hands instead of aligned with one wrist?
Yeah.
Okay.
So it's pretty much a little bit forward of your head. I mean, if it's back here, it's doing you no good. If it's that forward, you have nowhere to go. A distinction that's not made in the text, but it's often made by German practitioners, is that forward like this in a flug or an ox is often called a hanger or an executioner, because that's your finishing move. You're fitting in there, you're doing your thrust, and that's very often how I work my sparring. Through those executioners. So turn your pillions at 45 degrees on the front side.